Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Blazor DataGrid component of Syncfusion. In general, DataGrid is used to visualize raw data in a tabular format. So in this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Blazor DataGrid component of Syncfusion to a server-side Blazor application. I'll also show you how to populate and customize the tabular data in a grid and enable a few of its important features, like paging, sorting, filtering, and grouping. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create Blazor applications either using Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with the .NET Core SDK version 3.1.2. Now open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Select Blazor App from the template and click the Next button. To create a Blazor project, I will choose the Blazor Server app. The project has been created and is ready to use. Now I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a data grid to it. To add and start using a data grid, first I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I'll open the NuGet Package Manager and I search for Syncfusion Blazor and install it into my application. This will install all the required Syncfusion Blazor packages. Then, within the imports.razor file, I'll import the Syncfusion Blazor Grid's namespace. I navigate to the start.cs file and add to the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. And then add the Syncfusion Blazor service inside the configured services method. And then within the configure method, I'll also register the Syncfusion license by passing the trial license key in the register license method. Next, I'll navigate to the host.cshtml page to add a CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. To add the grid, I navigate to the index component. And here I'll include the sfgrid tag. The grid is not visually displayed on the browser now, as there's no data bound to it. To visualize the data grid on the browser page, I need to bind data to it. So, I'm going to show you how to add data to the grid to see its basic look and functionality. I can directly write C# code here. So, I will define a model class order, and I'll add a field order ID. In the same way, I will define the other fields, customer ID, order date, and freight, with appropriate types. Now, let me create a list orders based on the order model class. I will use the onInitializedLifecycle to generate the enumerable object randomly for the fields order ID, customer ID, freight, and order date while initializing the component. Then, I will assign the orders object to the data source property. Here, you can see a simple grid displaying all the provided columns in the data source. Now, I will show you how to customize and display specific columns in the data grid. To do so, I will define the grid columns component inside the sfgrid tag. This grid columns component has several column-specific options to define and customize them, which I will cover in my upcoming video. Now, I will show you some basic options one by one. Here, I will define grid column and then include the field property to map the appropriate field name from the model class order. Then, I will include the header text property and set its value to order ID. The value that you assign this header text property will be displayed as the title for the grid columns. Then, I will add the text align property and set its value to right to align the text to the right side of the column. In the same way, I will define the other column fields. For the order date column, I will include an additional format property and set its value to D to display the short date pattern. And I'll set its type to date. As a note, DataGrid supports most of the standard C# date time formats. In the same way, here for the freight column, I applied the currency format. Now, let's see how to enable some of the important features of the DataGrid. I'll start with the paging feature. Imagine you have a huge number of records displayed on your grid, and you would like to view limited records per page. This is possible by enabling the paging feature in the grid. First, I will add the allowed paging property and set its value to true in the DataGrid code. In this example, I'm going to display 5 records on each page. I will define the grid page settings component and set the page size property value to 5. Now, let's check the output in the browser. You can see the grid displays 5 records on each page. Now, I'll show you how to sort the records in DataGrid. By enabling the sorting feature in the grid, you can sort the records either in ascending or descending order, simply by clicking on the appropriate column header. I will just add the allow sorting property and set its value to true. In this example, I am sorting the grid records based on the custom name column, just by clicking its header. There are some cases where you may need to filter and view the grid records based on specific criteria. To perform filtering, I need to include the allow filtering property and set its value to true. In the output, when I type some text value in the customer name column, the grid displays the matching records. If you need to group the records and view them in a hierarchical view based on a specific grid column value, then you need to enable the grouping feature. Here, I will add the allow grouping property and set its value to true in the grid. You can see here, when I drag the customer name column header and drop it into the group drop area, the grid data is grouped based on the customer name column. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen in this video. I have shown you how to create a new server-side project in Blazor and added Syncfusion packages to it. I have also shown you how to add a DataGrid component and bind a data source to it. And finally, I showed you how to enable a few of its important features like paging, sorting, filtering, and grouping. To learn more about our grid's features, you can check out our documentation link provided in the description below. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in this video's description. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video, and if you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.